Good morning. I am S. Raja Karnagaran, working as a professor and head Department of Mechanical Engineering, RAHMCO Institute of Technology. First of all, I sincerely thank Institution of Engineers for providing financial grant to our project development of smart humanoid flexogram. For developing this project, in addition to me, the other team members are Mr. S. Valaganesh, Assistant Professor of Mechanical Engineering, and the student members are Mr. N. Gopalakrishnan, Mr. V. Kannan, and Mr. T. Karthik Alai Siva. So we developed the project. The objective of this project is designing of user-friendly gripper to grasp both the symmetrical and non-symmetrical complex geometrical objects. This project design is proposed and it is modeled, analyzed and simulated using Creo parametric and ANSI softwares. After that, the fabrication of this gripper will be using 3D printing technology with the PLD. So then the operation and control will be carried out by using PLC, PA boards and pneumatic technologies, which enables gesture control, programming control and wireless control. Finally, the fabricated gripper will be tested with the different objects, both the symmetrical as well as non-symmetrical, for different applications. Based on the performance of results, it's found very suitable and it's very economical for the task. Some of the applications are, we tried this project for trapping the vegetables, fruits in food industries based on their allowable stresses. Based on the performance studies, it was found that the proposed device performs better compared to existing grippers effectively. Previously, this project was fabricated by using servo motors as a drives and Arduino as a controller. So by using that earlier version, we used to grasp the normal objects. But the advancement of this project is used to grasp both normal, symmetrical as well as unsymmetrical complex objects. So the future scope, we are planning to develop the project by using IoT and the mobile app development. So this is our future scope. Once again, I thank you, Institution of Engineers, for supporting us for the development of this project by providing a financial grant. We are expecting the same in future projects also. Thank you.
Hello everyone, our project is development of smart humanoid flexograph, and myself Karthik Alai Siva and my colleagues Kannan and Gopalakrishnan have done the project, and we are guided by Dr. S. Raja Karnavara and Mr. S. Valaganes. At this time, I really thank the Institute of Engineers for providing fund for our project. For this we have referred several literatures. For the first one we have referred for the modeling of the gripper, and for next we have referred for the gripping mechanism, and for another thing we have referred for field of application. From those literature survey we have identified a problem in a food industry, so we have developing a machine for that. Our problem objective is to develop a user-friendly gripper for different kind of objects with different pressure conditions. Our abstract is to propose a model which is to develop a gripper and which is holding different kind of objects with different pressure conditions. We have used SolidWorks and ANSI simulation softwares for modeling and analysis of those grippers, and we have used programmable logic controllers and Raspberry Pi for programming those kind of objects. We have used a methodology in which we have used a top-down approach for modeling and static structural analysis for analysis, and for programming we have used ladder diagram logic, and in fabrication of the project we have used 3D printing technology, in that fused decomposition modeling technology is used. The modeling of our project is explained by my colleague Kannan.
Hello everyone, myself Kannan. Now I am going to explain our 3D modeling. First of all, we have used SolidWorks 2018, and the approach we have followed is a top-down approach. And we have classified our humanoid flex of hand into different components. First of all, it is a distal. This is a primary part of our finger. Next, interlink, which connects us both the proximal and the distal. Next is the palm, and as you can see, the both the distal, proximal and interlink are connected in the palms. The whole setup, that is the palm and the fingers, are connected in the base plate, and the base plate, as you can see, there is a hole in which we can use a knob like fixture. We can place the finger on it. Next of all, we can see the dimensions of the hand, in which each and every finger dimensions are shown in the image. This is the dimensions of the base plate and the pin for connecting the proximal and distal. Next, selection of materials. In selection of materials, there are many 3D printing materials, but we have compared PLA and ABS, and then we have selected the PLA according to the high density and better strength to the weight ratio. We have selected the PLA. Next, coming to the pneumatic cylinder, we have used a double acting cylinder and one single double acting cylinder of 5 and one rotary acting cylinder. Next, coming to the calculation part, we have calculated only one calculation, that is a force acting on the material. We have calculated the force, that is a pressure into area. Pressure, we have used the working pressure 4 bar, and area, that is the cylinder cross section of the cylinder. Next, coming to the analysis part, we have used the software ANSYS. The factors we have analyzed is static structural stress. In static structural stress, we have concentrated in total deformation. In static structural stress, we have calculated two stresses. One is the maximum principal stress and the maximum shear stress. As you can see in the figure, we have calculated for each and every part of the component analyzed separately, and as you can see, the maximum principal stresses and maximum shear stresses for each of the parts. Now you can see the total deformation. At the total deformation, we can see only there is a minimum amount of total deformation that occurs on the palm. Next part is the programming. The programming part will be explained by Karthik Shiva.
As I said earlier, the programming of our part is done by using a microcontroller called Programmable Logic Controller, and we have used Codesys V2.3 software. With that, we have used ladder diagram logic. Actually, we have declared a global variable for our convenience. Here you can see a 3 rung in a PLC program what we have done for our gripper. First 2 rungs are mainly for starting the operation, and third rung we have incorporated the mechanisms with the timer, which is time controller. In this program, you can see, without declaring a global variable, the program looks so tedious and it is difficult to understand what it is. As I said earlier, the fabrication of our project is done by used fused decomposition modeling method in 3D printing technology, and we have designed and we have fabricated 16 parts in total. The budget of our project is around 20,207. The budget exceeds mainly due to 3D printing and pneumatic actuators and Raspberry Pi. In the Raspberry Pi, we are going to utilize it in future, and we have purchased 2 solenoid valves for that. One is for rotary cylinder and one is for 5 linear actuators. And color sensor we have purchased, which is going to utilize in future works. Conveyor system is designed for moving the materials, and USB adapter and relay, which is to interface the Raspberry Pi and PLC softwares. Bolt and nuts are for additional attachments. In our future, we are going to develop it with the image sensor, and we are going to enable a gesture control with it. So these are the reference we have referred mainly for this project. Thank you.
project we are using the R&D fund given by Institute of Engineers. So this is the PLC what we have used for this project, and this is the EC board that it is widely used for research purpose in our college. So we have used some other wards here. This is actually from the electrical signal from PLC and the output which is given to the pneumatic actuators. And this is the pressure control sensor which is used to reduce the pressure which is coming from the compressor. So this is the flow control valve which is used to control the flow rate of the air. So this is the push button which is used to start and stop the operations. So these are all the distributors and foreign units provided. So here in this we have attached 5 linear cylinders here for 5 fingers and one rotary cylinder above the table. It is used for rotary motion which is to be given. So this is the program what we have used for that. In this we have used a V2.3 software for programming this operation. So in that we have used a ladder logic. This rung shows the every rung which shows the operations of the PLC which is to be connected to pneumatic supply, and the timer which is also given for increasing or reducing the time of each operation. So this is actually a conveyor what we have designed additionally for this to carry the objects. Thank you.
Hello everyone. So I am going to discuss about the design portion of this humanoid flexograph. So you have see the black color portion of this humanoid flexograph. This is called as POM. It is made up of PLA, polylactic acid, with the help of 3D printing technologies. There are various sort of fingers are there. So this is called as distal, and this is called as interlink, and this is called as proximal. So there are various components has been 3D printed, and along with there are several type of links and joints are put together. You may see these are all the links and joints which is used to connect the piston and the finger of our humanoid flexograph. So these are all the linear actuators which we purchased from the market. So the bore length of this linear actuator is 12 mm and its stroke length is around 50 mm. We already fabricated one gripper earlier. So this is run by with the help of servo motor and Arduino as a main controller. So with that we are going to gripper a normal object to grip symmetrical as well as non-symmetrical object. We are going to place this kind of gripper. Again, there are some sort of drawbacks while we designing this kind of gripper. We have analyzed the problem with the help of ANSI software in order to detect how much amount of stress induced in this along with some deformation parameters. We program this gripper with the help of programmable logic controller. So here it is a programmable logic controller. It has 8 analog input, 8 digital input and 8 digital output. So the software which we used in PLC programming is Codesys version 2.3 and method of programming is ladder diagram. So these are all the major parameters what we took in this project. Along with that, in our future work we are going to design a conveyor belt which carries some sort of material, and that incoming material is sensed by the color sensor TCS2300. We are going to place this sensor and we are going to program this sensor to detect the color of an incoming object. Along with that, we purchased Raspberry Pi, but we are not using Raspberry Pi for this project right now. We are going to upgrade this project with the help of Raspberry Pi and Internet of Things parameters. By developing some modern application, we may interface Raspberry Pi along with our project, and we are also planning to interface Raspberry Pi with our programmable logic controller in order to complete the entire automation station. I hope you may get some clear idea about this project. The project has been already demonstrated by our students. Once again, I finally thank Institution of Engineers for providing such a wonderful financial support for our development of smart humanoid flexograph. We are expecting the same in future. Thank you.